Please subscribe the channel and don't forget to click the bell icon.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to Botanica. So we were talking about the somatic embryogenesis and the different types of somatic embryogenesis. We have discussed about what we have, that a direct type of somatic embryogenesis and indirect somatic embryogenesis, and the main difference between these two is the presence of intervening stage or intermediate stage in the indirect method by indirect type, while in direct type of somatic embryogenesis there is no intervening stage and there is a direct conversion of a somatic cell into an embryogenic cells. Now we turn our attention to next topic, methods and approaches, where we are going to discuss the methodology of the somatic embryogenesis, how the cells are isolated, the somatic cells, how they are isolated, what type of cells should be isolated, what type of cells should be cultured for somatic embryogenesis, what are the different types of culture media which are used here, how to prepare the culture media, and the incubation and sterilization, aseptic techniques, and at the end we are going to see that how we are getting the complete new plant by the process of somatic embryogenesis. So we are now on the methods and approaches, the methods which are used to for the somatic embryogenesis. So as far as the procedure is described, which we are discussing in the next, that is that this process has the embryos from explant that pass through a callus phase. So remember, here we are talking about the indirect type of somatic embryogenesis. We are not going to discuss the direct type of somatic embryogenesis, because the major complications and complex things are here in the indirect type of somatic embryogenesis and indirect, because what happens in indirect and indirect somatic embryogenesis, because first we have to make a cell, plant has to, tissue has to make a callus, undifferentiated mass of cell, then we have to direct that callus cells towards the embryo formation. So first of all, we have a selection of cultivar and type of explant, but remember, we are discussing about the indirect type of somatic embryogenesis. We are not discussing the direct somatic embryogenesis. So as far as the cultivar and the explant source and type are concerned, they are very essential, they are very important for as far as the plant tissue culture experiment is concerned, because in many factors, which are responsible or which affect the outcome of our plant tissue culture experiment, one of the major factor is the source of the explant and also the cultivar selection. Why the cultivar selection is important? Because when we talk about any species in the somatic embryogenesis, that every cultivar has a different set of genes. It has a different genome, different genotype, distinct genotype, and it has a significant variation from the other types of cultivar. So that's why, and as we know that all the protein content of the cells and the plant is determined by the genes. So that's why genotype is very important. So what type of proteins are produced, what type of proteins are not produced, or the plant is not able to produce those new proteins, what type of signaling and what type of cells or what type of mechanism and metabolism is going on into the cell. So it all depends upon the genotype of that cell. So that's why cultivar selection. Why cultivar selection is important? Because every cultivar has a different set of genes, it has a different genotype from others. So, and all the morphology, or we can say that the phenotype, is dependent or it is determined by the genotype, the genes. So that's why it is important to select a proper cultivar from which we are getting this cultivar from which we are getting the cells or the somatic cells. So examples of this can be, for example, we have a cotton, soybean, safflower, barley and wheat. So these are the example, and you can see that If you have not seen in other varieties, but you have definitely seen different types of cultivars in wheat. So when you look at the different types of cultivar which are growing in the field, so you will clear cut differentiate between the two cultivars. It is as their kernel colors are different, the height is different, their overall appearance is different, and similarly when things come towards the yield of that particular cultivar, so yield is also different as the one variety or the one cultivar of the wheat has a greater yield, and other variety or cultivar has a less yield. And similarly, those cultivars yield is dependent upon the area where that particular cultivar is growing. So these are all the factors which contribute towards the yield of that particular wheat. So that's why as there are various variations in the cultivar, so it is more important, it is essential for a plant tissue culture to get that type of cultivar which should be beneficial, and it should be respondent to the plant tissue culture experiment. So in genus Medicago, in the Fabaceae, special genotypes have been produced by selection and breeding in the case of Medicago sativa. So what we have in the Medicago, there is a selection, as there is a making of a new genotype in the, if we have a different varieties in the wheat. So similar is the case here with the Medicago, that the special type of genotypes have been made, they have been produced, and by the long lasting or by the long hardship and long efforts of selection and breeding. So this is the process by which the agriculture specialists, they produce new cultivars and new species. What is the selection that when we have grown as one variety, we have a two, or we can say that we have a two varieties which are growing in the different areas, or which are growing in the two different fields which is adjacent to one another. So there will be some beneficial characters in one variety, and some of the beneficial characters are present in the other variety. So this is the process of selection, that we will merge these both beneficial things from these two different varieties, and we are going to converge them, we are going to merge them in a single variety. So this is the process of selection. And this particular selection of the beneficial or the advantageous characters for us, this is carried out by the process of breeding, that they are interbred at various levels, and what we get at the end, we get a species which is beneficial for us. For example, we can say that there are certain characters for in the wheat we are concerned with the yield. So that variety which has a more yield, which is more vigorously growing, which is has a strong stem, so that it should elevate it to the level so that it should be complete, it should complete its life cycle and the time. So these are the different characters which are beneficial for us. So they are merged at one variety by the process of selection and breeding. So in the genus Medicago, the special genotypes, they have been made as far as the needs are concerned in the plant tissue culture. So in Medicago catula, by an initial cycle of tissue culture to produce a regenerated plant which was used as a source of seed for selection over four generations. So what happened in the Medicago truncatula, that they have sown or they have cultivated that particular variety by the process of plant tissue culture, and that variety or that plant was not growing in a natural condition, and then they regenerated plant by the process of tissue culture, and that regenerated plant by the plant tissue culture experiment, that was used as a source of seed for the selection for next four generation. And when we get all these varieties and all these beneficial characters after four generations, so where we are going to make it for the normal process for growing in the natural condition, and also we can use it for as a source for a X plant. So the enhancement of somatic embryogenesis in plants that have been regenerated from tissue culture has also been observed in sunflower. carrot and wheat. So these are the other examples where what happened, that enhancement occurs in the somatic embryogenesis, that those plants which were generated by them, that were not isolated, and that the source was not from the normal environment, natural environment, but source was the previously grown plant in a tissue culture experiment, and the explant it was serving as a explant source. So these are also certain condition that sometimes we are not getting the explant from the natural condition, from the wild plant, or we can say that the normally grown plants in the field or in the laboratory, but we are going to culture that plant by the process of tissue culture, and when that cultured plant is grown, we are making or we are using it as a source of explant. So this is not limited to the Medicago species Fabaceae family, it is also in the sunflower, carrot and wheat. So if a species has not been regenerated previously by somatic embryogenesis, then it is important to test a number of different cultivars. So it is another way, alternative mechanism to select a prominent, to select a respondent, and to select a successful type of cultivar which has a set of gene which should be respondent to the tissue culture experiment, and it should be according to the nature of the experiment. So if we for example, if we are going to we are going to conduct experiment on a different or on a new variety, so this is not the case that we get one cultivar or one variety of that species and we are going to culture it in the plant tissue culture, and we will publish our result, and we will make the generalization and the rules about that variety. So it is not the case. So whenever we are carrying out experiment on a new variety species, so we have to conduct experiment on different types of cultivars. So when experimenting these cultivars, so we will be able to mark the differences between the responses of these different cultivars, and at the end when we have checked all these cultivars, when we have cultured all these cultivars, so we will be able to mark the generalization, that these are the generalization and these are specific to these cultivars. So it should be this practice should be used. So if the plant is recalcitrant but some regeneration occurs, then test the tissue from the regenerated plant for increased somatic embryogenesis. So what happened, there are some plants, there are recalcitrant nature, they are, for example, we can say that hard in nature. So what happens that there are certain tissues which are regenerating and other tissues are not responding. So it is also the case when we are talking about the cultivars. So we can say that this is the, for example, this is a phloem tissue, or this is a xylem tissue, or mesophyll cells, or mesophyll tissue. So what happens here, one type of tissue is more responsive, it has a more response than the other. So within the cultivar, so it is also important, first we have to select the one cultivar which is more responsive and which has more success in a plant tissue culture, and then we are going to select a particular tissue in that cultivar so that our experiment should be successful. So the next question, which is very much understandable and which is very much at the time that it arises, what tissue should be used as an explant, since we are discussing here in the previous discussion that there are differences in the responses of different types of tissues. So what type of tissues should be selected? So as we can say that we have selected the cultivar, so we have the cultivar, so what should next we do? What type of tissue we are going to isolate? So there is a wide range of source of tissues which are used here in the experiment. So the first piece of information that is helpful is to determine what explants are used in a closely related species, genus or family. For example, if we are carrying out experiments on the for example a medicago or on the wheat, so when we are conducting the experiment first time, so first we did some research on the literature which is previously available. So by the literature, by reading the literature, by conducting some research on the literature, we will come to know that What type of sources of the explant were used in the closely related species, or the genus of the of the same species, or the related species of that which we are going to use as an explant in the tissue culture experiment or somatic embryogenesis experiment. So that's why. So first piece of information or the first clue for the selecting the plant tissue culture or X type of X plant is that to determine by the using the previous literature that what type of X plant were used, what type of tissues were used in the related species, or we can say that the species within the same genera. For example, we have a Triticum genus in the wheat. Wheat belong to the genus Triticum. So, if we are conducting our experiment on the Triticum estivum species, so we will first do some research and we will go through that what type of explant were used in the previous experiment which were conducted on the species related to genus Triticum. Similar is the case with the, for example, the Medicago. So, if we are going to conduct the experiment in Medicago polymorpha, so first, what we will do, we do some research, we read some literature in the which was published previously, and we will come to know that what type of explant or what type of tissue was used. So those zygotic embryos are a popular source of tissues, as somatic embryos will form more readily from cells that are already in an embryonic stage. So mostly what is the reason behind that we are isolating or we are using zygotic embryos as a or other tissues in a meristematic state, we can also use those. But the zygotic embryos are used here in the somatic embryogenesis because those cells are in advance, they are committed to form embryo. So they contain mostly all the genes which are expressed there, and those cells are very much readily ready for the formation of the embryo. So as they are committed for the embryo formation, so what we will do, so it will require low effort for us to make them the somatic embryos. So these are the source of tissues, as a somatic embryo will form more readily from cells that are already in an embryonic stage. So from the broad consideration, so when we are discussing the different species, so it is also come to know that in the previous literature that there is a different responses in different types of species. For example, there is a different response in the monocot families, there is a different response in the dicot and monocot, and in the dicot there are different families, they are different in their sources of explant. For example, Solanaceae is more amenable to regeneration than the Fabaceae or the Gramineae. So when we have compared the regeneration capacity or regeneration ability of the family Solanaceae, plants of the family Solanaceae, so what come to know that the regeneration process or the regeneration experiment, they are more amenable than the when we are comparing them with the Fabaceae or the Gramineae, while the monocotyledons often require less differentiated tissue. Utilizing the embryo at the appropriate stage can be important. So you can make a difference, or you can compare these two. So in the first sentence we are talking about, or in the about the dicot, that there are different families which have different responses to regeneration. While in monocotyledon, so there is some response or some difference between the different families, but the success in a monocot, it depends on other factors, like they require a less differentiated tissue, the undifferentiated mass of cell they require for the somatic embryogenesis, and utilizing the embryo. So what stage of the embryo we are at, the what stage development stage of the embryo we are isolating the embryo from the explant. So these two things are more important in the monocotyledons. So these two factors will determine the success of our experiment in somatic embryogenesis when we are carrying out experiment in the monocot. So there is a difference in the selection of the, so as far as the sources of the explants are concerned, they are different, and these depends upon the different types of, we can say that the families within the genus it is also different. In the species we have also different types of responses, and when we are talking about the cultivar, so there is also different responses, and in the cultivar we have different types of tissues which are which have a different responses, various types of responses toward the plant tissue culture. So these are all the all things which are kept in the mind before starting the experiment of plant tissue culture, so that we will get 100% result of our experiment.